Let's talk about Brainfuck. Hey Henry, what's Brainfuck? I hear echo from the back of a darkened warehouse. The word Brainfuck is a portmanteau of two verbs, to brain and to fuck. It's an esolang created by an absolute genius called Urban Müller. The language consists of only 8 very simple commands. Angry brows, worried brows, plus sign, minus sign, monster sad, monster smile, dot, and sleepy dot. Imagine, if you will, a long terrifying worm made up of infinite memory locations, each with a big zero written on them. Brainfuck works by manipulating these memory locations using the previously mentioned commands. Angry brows and worried brows navigate left and right through each memory location. Plus and minus signs add or subtract 1 from the current memory location. Dot tells the worm to scream out the value at the top of its lungs in the currently selected memory location. Sleepy Dot shouts 1 byte of information at the worm and stores it in the current location. And finally, Monster Smile and Monster Sad are loop indicators. Monster Sad looks at the value of the current location. If it's a 0, it skips the next Monster Smile in the code. Otherwise, it just executes the next command. Monster Smile looks at the value of the current location. If it is not 0, it jumps to its matching Monster Sad command and carries out the next instruction. Got that? Me neither. Let's have a play around. This program prints out the letter A. This program doesn't. This program shows the message Hello World. This does it better. But let's have a closer look at what's actually happening here. Here's a simple program that we can pick apart. I've separated this program into 3 lines so we can actually read it. First line adds 54 to the memory location 1, prints it, and then moves on to the next memory location. The second line adds 36 to the memory location, prints it, and then moves back to the first memory location. The last bit's where the magic happens. Starting with the first memory location, it begins the loop as the first memory location has a 54 in it. It subtracts 1 from this and moves on to the second memory location, adds 1 to that, and then moves back to the memory location 1. The final bracket will cause this to repeat until the value in memory location 1 is 0. It then moves to memory location 2 and then displays this value. Here's the output we get overall. So it gives. What was actually output here are integers converted into ASCII values. The first 2 digits, 6 and dollar signs, have ASCII values of 54 and 36, the 2 numbers that we have on lines 1 and 2. The third digit, Z, has an ASCII value of 90. 54, 36, 90. Now we should be able to see what this program's actually done. Yep. All that effort to add 2 values together. And of course it gets so much worse. So much worse. This program outputs all the square numbers from 0 to 10,000. This program continuously outputs the Fibonacci sequence. This program prints out a picture of a wine glass. And this monstrosity prints out a picture of a knight chess piece. Well, I don't know about you, but my eyes are reasonably well boiled. I'm gonna go lie down and scream a lot. But in all honesty, I actually really like the language. It's simple, easy to learn, and can produce pretty complex behavior from only a handful of instructions. It just looks fucking terrible. Thanks loads for watching. If you want to try out this language for yourself, there's some links in the description. Let's see what you can make. Otherwise, remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this, and I'll see you next time.